And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. I love Christmas, don't you? I love singing songs that tell the Christmas story and candlelight Christmas Eve services. I love riding around and seeing how the neighbors have covered their houses with lights. And how about unpacking special ornaments year after year and finding just the right place for them on the tree? I love homemade Christmas cookies and candy, and I'll admit it, I love Christmas presents, both giving them and getting them. Maybe it's because Christmas really is all about giving. It's all about God giving a gift that has brought joy to the world ever since.
Thank you.
a gift, the angel's amazing words to Mary that she would have a child. She couldn't wrap her mind around how it could happen. Joseph was confused and hurt, but then obedient to the angel's instructions. Then came the long journey, the crowded inn, and the stable. No, it didn't seem like a gift at first. Oh, but what a gift to be there when God himself came as a precious little baby. A new star shone down and wrapped the whole scene in a holy light. The first Christmas gift the world had ever known. In the hills near Bethlehem, some average guys were just doing their job one night when they were nearly frightened to death by a host of angels. After scrambling off to Bethlehem, stumbling into the dark stable, and coming face to face with the Messiah, these ordinary shepherds recognized that they were in the presence of God's glory. What else was there to do but bow and worship? Was her first baby, unexpected to be sure, unbelievable in how and why he came, and unimaginable in his humility. Under ordinary circumstances, he might even have been unwanted. Yet that night in Bethlehem, Mary cradled him close and searched his tiny face. In that moment, she was overwhelmed with love for the gift she had received.
Isn't he?
When we're little, our list of favorite Christmas gifts includes things like dolls and toy cars and trucks and games. As we grow older, that list changes to the gifts of family, being together, and being able to share with those we love. For believers, the gift that is always at the top of our list was given more than 2,000 years ago. Because of it, our world is different. Our lives are changed. Grace and mercy, hope and peace have flowed from Jesus down through the ages, and they reach us today. He still speaks through his word, pours out his love, and extends his offer of life to anyone who wants to receive it. Because we know Jesus, our greatest privilege now is to do our part in passing the gift along through our testimonies, our songs, and especially the lives we live. We offer the gift to others. It's like a present we have chosen carefully and wrapped, anticipating the moment the recipient will open it and exclaim, "Oh, it's just what I wanted." Together we look forward to the moment we will come into His presence and thank Him for all He has done for us.
There was a holy hush all over as I walked into the room, and as I stood before Him face to face, I was gloriously made new. There was a great and awesome presence, and the light as bright as day. And as I bowed to kneel with the angels, I heard the Spirit. As I looked at those around me with their hands uplifted high, the Spirit laid His hands on me and I uplifted mine. We were singing hallelujah, praises to His name, and as I bowed to kneel with the angels, I heard the Spirit say,
so here's your Christmas gift, meant especially for you, prepared with you in mind, sent to prove that God loves you. Maybe this is your Christmas to reach out and accept it. Maybe this is your year to say, "Thank you, God, for the gift of your Son. Now I'll do my part to make sure the gift goes on."